Hello and welcome to today's Table of Contents tutorial. With InDesign it's really easy to create your Table of Contents. It's created automatically and can be customized very easily. As always, you find the documents we're using today on our website so you can download them. If you're ready, we can start.
We start by creating a Table of Contents style. You find those in Layout and Table of Contents Styles. We're going to create a new one and we call this My TOC. The title is the title that will show up on your page. We can call it Table of Contents. I want to create a paragraph style for this Table of Contents, the headline. So we're going to create a new one and we call it TOC Head. It should be based on font. And I would say we could increase the size as it is a headline. And we have it also bold. This should be alright, and we can click on OK. Then we are choosing which styles we actually want to put into our table of contents. We have used some styles as a headline, head 1, 2, head 3, and we're going to add all of those into included paragraph styles. And we also keep the hierarchical order, so this is level 3. The next step is to create a specific paragraph style for each headline. This is a paragraph style that will be only active in our table of contents. We're going to do this in entry style, and also here we want to create a new paragraph style. We call this one TOC1. As always, we want to have it based on font, and as this is our main headline, we also want to have it bold. Then we need to go to tabs, and we need to define a spacing. So we would have a number here and then the text. So we're going to insert a left justify tab and we're going to place it approximately here. We set it to 10 millimeters. Then we need to place another one on the right side. And this one should be a right justify tab. This one will keep our number. We're going to push it to the side to have it on the edge of the page and we can go on OK. For head 2 we also create a new paragraph style. We call this one TOC2 and we have it based on the font as well. But this time we don't want to have it bold. In the tabs panel we need to get a little indent, so we set this to 10 millimeters. Then we want again a left justify tab at the position of 20 millimeters, and on the right edge of the paper we want to have a right justify tab again. If we now add leader, add a point and two spaces, we will get a dotted line in the table of contents. Finally, we're going to set the same thing for head 3. We call it TOC3. It's based again on font and it's regular style. This time we're going to have an indent of 20 millimeters and a tab at 30 millimeters. Also over here, we want to have again a right justify tab and we push it to the edge. We are going to use the same dots in here as well. One point and two spaces. We can go on OK. We want to include the full paragraph to get the numbering of the headlines as well. You can click on OK and on OK again. And if you want to insert a table of contents, you can go on Layout, Table of Contents. And with my table of contents selected, we can go on OK. And just click, and here's our table of contents. We can see now that here might be something wrong, so I want to check this again. It's in TOC2, tabs, and we see this is pointing to the wrong side. Should be this side. And you see the difference between those two. this should be fine now. You can go on OK again. And there you have it. Now you can do some further adjustments. For example, I would like to increase the spacing between the headline and the first paragraph here. This is of course in the paragraph styles. And we just will add 5 millimeters in here. And if I go on the paragraph styles and go on redefine style, I'm going to apply this to this style. Because if I don't apply this and I update the table of contents, it will take the styles as they are here and will discard the changes I'm doing now. So it's important to always redefine the style in here. I want to get some spacing between the lines. So I'm going to try and add 2 millimeters as the spacing. As always, redefine style. And we also need to do this for each sub-level of the table of contents. This looks alright. So we can zoom out. And we delete the old table of contents. You can take the text frame and delete it. Place our table in here. And going to drag the text frame that fills the whole page. If you get a plus sign down here, you would need to add a new page. So basically you would insert a new page and thread the new text frame over here. If you now change something down in your headlines, for example, just write something more, you can go back. And if you want to update your table of contents, you have to go with the cursor into your table. And at layout, you can go on update table of contents. And you see now the text we added also appears here. If you want to do changes in your headlines, you never do it in here. You always do it directly on your headlines. The last thing you might want to do is to clean up your paragraph styles. So we're going to the toolbox and create a new folder in here. And we call this one TOC. And we are throwing all our TOC styles into this folder. Yep, this should be fine. Now it's less messy in here. So that's it basically for today. And here we have our nice table of contents. See you next time where we talk about how to create references. Bye!